About to go on Mission Peak right now. Kind of tired, but gotta fight through it. All right, let's go. Super hot today. That's why we're waking up early so we can beat the heat wave. And it's just me today, solo dolo. I don't think I'm gonna go all the way to the top just because the last stretch is very steep. We'll see. I'm gonna do as much as I can today. Told you Mission Peak would be sun blazing. This is 6 a.m. right now. It's just so steep. I think I'm going to go for a little bit more after that, turn around. So far I'm like 2 miles incline right now. There's Tesla over there, that big white building. Probably one of the last few times that I do this trail. All right, time to head back. Probably gonna drop down this to be quicker.
Let's go, 4.76 miles. Best feeling right here. I could have made it to the top. I just don't like to because the last stretch isn't really a trail. It's more of like rock climbing. So yeah, I wanted to finish the hike and be back at my car within an hour, but my end time was an hour and 13 minutes, which isn't too bad. 40 minutes hike up and then 30 minutes jog down. Right now I'm gonna go home, make breakfast, and then I'm probably gonna wash the car. After that, I'll show you guys some of the pickups that I've been copying over the last 6 to 8 months. Black pepper is essential. You need black pepper. Final touch. And there you have a simple breakfast. Thank you. on. We got a few pickups. Everything has accumulated over the last like 6 to 8 months. Bought a couple t-shirts, a couple jackets, some pants, and also some recent pickups from my trip in Honolulu. Most of the shirts I wear are size large or extra large. So I have this Harley Davidson shirt that says size does matter, with a motorcycle engine at the background. The back of it just shows the location. Originally I bought this because of the graphic. I like the print, the colors. This one is a size extra large. It fits great on the body. I like to wear my t-shirts flowy. I would describe my style as very Californian. Just wearing what I feel like is me and comfortable at the same time. Most of the shirts that I buy recently are black, just because I wear a lot of black clothing. So that's that. Next, I got another Harley Davidson shirt. I bought this one for my trip to Hawaii. I just thought it fit the occasion. And the graphics is cool. Palm trees, motorcycle. This one is a size extra large. Next, I got a Marlboro t-shirt. I just like the graphics on the front, simple, plain, pocket tee, print on the back. This one is also a size extra large, but fits more like a true size large. And I bought this a while ago. I just like how it's kind of like a caution logo with the drummer in the back. Also a size extra large, don't know where it's from, just like the faded print. This one is a very faded Nike t-shirt. A sun faded tee, extra faded along the shoulder lines. Originally, I think this shirt was black. You can see the black stitching. Very faded, thrashed, and I just like how it looked. This one is also size extra large, but it fits more like a flowy medium large. I like how this fit and looks. And picked up this navy Russell crew neck. Just something to throw on at night when it gets a little bit chilly out here in California. Nothing much to say about this. I also got this Chrome Hearts Oval Cross belt back when they released this on their website in November. They only did it for a weekend. I was lucky enough to purchase this on their website. Super happy with this. Goes well with everything. Shorts, pants, and probably my favorite belt. So first jacket I bought during the winter time was this Jacob jacket. Kind of reminds me of the Alix Moncler almond jacket. Overall great production. The hood is actually detachable. You kind of rock it like this. Very tight on the body, gives it more of that slim fit look, unlike most puffer jackets where it makes you look a little bit oversized. This is a very fitted puffer jacket from Jacob, and colorway is amazing. I like the extra over dyed along the lines and creases of the jacket. Next we have a Levi denim jacket. This one's a size large. I don't really wear denim jackets just because usually when I wear something I like to be comfortable, and unfortunately denim jackets doesn't provide that kind of comfort and stability for me. I have very little wear out of this. I like to wear a t-shirt underneath. Hoodies will kind of make my arms feel a little bit too restricted. It's always nice to keep a blue denim jacket in your closet. Next I have a black denim jacket that's a bit faded. This one's a size extra large. Sometimes I would cuff the sleeve because it is a bit lengthy for my arms. I might get more wear out of this during the fall and winter. With the hoodie underneath, it looks really nice. I picked up this green windbreaker from Uniqlo. It's light and simple. You could wear this to layer up or dress down. I like the army green look. This is like my second or third plain hoodie. This is a Yeezy Gap hoodie. This one's a size large. It fits very cropped. Picked this up because I wanted a comfortable black hoodie that I could wear on a regular basis. So this is one of the pieces that I picked up that I was actually super excited about. Picked this up in December in the winter time at Chrome Hearts in LA. It's a quarter fleece zip up at nylon material. The lining down below, dagger zipper, kangaroo pockets. It comes with a tightening clasp. Details are amazing. Quality is amazing. Fleece material on interior and exterior. Definitely going to get a lot of wear out of this during the fall and winter time. One of my favorite pickups this past year. And I bought this when I went to Hawaii, went to Harley Davidson. I really like how it showed the island on the chest. Just a pickup to pick up. Also got another pair of carpenter pants, blue Carhartt, light blue double knee pants. Originally it had a bunch of holes in this, but I wanted to get some wear out of it, so I brought it to my tailor and she did an amazing job with repairing the denims. So there was a fat hole in the crotch area, and then did some stitching over it. There's a lot of airflow going through my leg, so I asked if she could just cover it up with another piece of fabric and just scribble some stitching over it. She actually stitched it over in blue stitching. One of my favorite pants, fits great. It has a little patch on the left pocket. Gives it a little bit of character. I love these pants. Bought these for $40 on eBay. And I wouldn't recommend anyone to buy these, but when I seen them in store, I just had to have it. I've been looking for these pants for quite a while now, and I'm glad that Chrome Hearts Honolulu had them. They normally don't sell this leather pants, I think, in stores, but I asked the associate if she had any new pieces that came in. She pulled out the double knee carpenter pants, which I liked a lot, but once she pulled out the leather carpenter pants, they were the perfect size, and I've been struggling to find my size for quite a while now. I've been telling myself that if I see them in person, then I might just have to do it, but I knew later on I would eventually get them because, you know, you could still special order them. I've been getting lucky with the Chrome Hearts pieces, honestly, like going into the stores. I'm glad I got the last one and it's in my size. But these leather pants, they're crazy. I haven't opened this since I came back from Hawaii. They're unboxing for you guys. Details are amazing. Leather dagger double knee carpenter pants. These things are heavy as fuck. Literally the craziest pair of pants I own and will ever own. The lining of it is super soft, made out of the silk material. These were the ones that sparked my interest in leather carpenter pants. When I couldn't find these, I actually went and bought this pair. This one is a pair of trousers from Fujiday. They're also a leather carpenter style. I believe this is the same leather that they use for Prada. This material was sourced in Italy. Don't get me wrong, like, these are a great pair of trousers, but the fit of this is completely off. It has two snap buttons along with an extra button to go through this loop. But what this does is that it loses an extra inch. Even though they said size 2 equates to a size 33, it really doesn't. It's actually more of a 31 than 33. Next, some Chrome Hearts. I haven't opened this one yet. Got the new Maddie Boy hoodie that released in stores. So you guys probably seen this one already, but I got the cemetery ring, special ordered this one. Also got this SBT ring, I think that's what it's called. Some symbols like vines with crosses on each of the corners. I've been having this one. Also had this crosstail ring for some time now. These are the two new pickups right here, and I'm happy with it. Also bought these earrings, the cross with a diamond. About to go meet up with my homie Tokyo right now. We're gonna do a photo shoot for his clothing brand. Should be exciting.
Let's go. Yeah. I said for the other side, they don't live by the code. I spent about a half a ticket just this year alone. Seems like anything I do, they still say I'm a clone. Seems like I'm doing something right, I can't get left alone. I got ex bitches saying they proud of me and they stay blowing up my phone. Ooh, taking next pills in the hills, fucking on the actress from the Netflix show. Let's go. Young nigga from DC, they copy the flow straight down to what I smoke. Ho, young nigga from DC, I bet the sheets in front of the West Coast. I'm doing better and better alone. But it would be selfish for me to say I did this shit on my own.